You've got to speak a language that the earth can understand. The only reason you don't have earth in your life, the kind of earth you want in your life, is because you never gave it the word of the Lord. Oh, earth, 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 hear the word of the Lord. And when you start to understand the word of the Lord coming into your life, you got to speak it. Pastor, what does that say to you here? Say to you.
That lets me know that earth, in earth there's riches. In earth there's mysteries untold. And if I want the revelation, if I want earth to reveal herself to me, then I must begin to speak and begin to prophesy to earth so that earth can open up herself to me. When you speak to someone, they always get, you get the attention. And see, many of you have been trying to get things attention, but the reason why they haven't given you their attention is because you have not called it by their name. But once you call that thing by name, it will give itself your its attention, and it will obey you and begin to manifest for you.
Amen. See, all things have ears. Psalms 103 and verse 20 in closing said, bless the Lord, ye his angels that excel in strength, that do his commandments, hearkening unto the voice of his word. See, angels can only hearken to the word that is voiced. If you don't give voice to the word of the Lord, your angel can't hearken. And many of you, your angels are unemployed because you've never employed them. The Bible says the angels of the Lord is encamped. That means you got a camp of angels around you. You got a camp of angels around you, Prophet Simmons. You got a camp of angels around you, Prophet Wright. You got a camp of angels around you, Prophetess Deborah. You have a camp of angels around you, Prophetess Kelly. But the question is, did you voice any of God's word so that his angels that excel in strength, that do his commandments, could hearken unto the word you voiced? See, this is part of angel writing.
Retreat.
You got to speak to your angels. You got to have some times in your devotion where you start commanding angels.
Yes, you must.
And you start speaking the voice of the word of the Lord. You start saying, I told you the other day I had some prayer beads. A few years ago I had to get this property, and I took the prayer beads because my money was acting funny. Any of you ever had funny money? And I had to find $700,000, and it wasn't coming in the way I needed to. So I went and got in the, because I was in the Orthodox, you know, in the Orthodox church, they had a prayer rope, and I had my prayer rope, and it's about 33 knots on it. And I went around all day saying, I and my Father are one. 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 I was driving saying, I and my Father are one. I and my Father are one. When I had people in the car, I said, you're just, excuse me, I'm in a season of meditation right now. I go, I and my Father are one. I and my Father are one. I wore that prayer rope out for about a month or so. I went to bed with it. I and my Father are one. I went to sleep pulling off each knot. I am my Father. And nobody knew what I was doing. I was in consciousness. I am my Father one. Until one day, I was saying, I am my Father one, until the Lord gave me another mantra and said, say, I am my Father financially one. So I started saying, I and my Father are financially one. I am my Father are financially one. I am my Father are financially one. And I started saying, my Father and I are financially one. My Father and I are financially one. My Father and I are financially one. And the Spirit just started working with me until I started coming out with stuff like, I am money. I am money. I am one. I am one. I am infinite. I am infinite resources, infinite money, infinite good, infinite debt. Money comes to me all the time. Money is seeking me. Money is seeking me. Money. And see, I kept working with that. Next thing I know, the money manifests. But what I think also happened is my angels were saying, wow, he's finally employing us. Next thing I know, about $10,000, somebody said, I was in Germany and you were on my mind. And out of Germany, someone sent $10,000 in here. This is for you, Bishop. Prophets, you remember that? Somebody else. And then they came back again and says, here's another $5,000 or $10,000, $20,000. Money was just coming all over places. And I kept remember God said, don't limit the Holy One of Israel. Don't tell me where to bring it from. Just say, I am my father, I financially won. And I was working that rib. I wore that prayer rope out. You know what? I feel like digging up my prayer rope here. Jesus, I think I got it somewhere in my bag in there. Amen. Back. Amen. I wore that prayer rope out. And see, that's when you start getting into a state of consciousness. Until your consciousness start bringing about your beingness. Yeah, see, people that are walking around with beads, it's really meditation rope. I call it the teething ring, because it's like the teething ring. It's the toddler's format of the meditation. It helps you to keep focus. Because see, the mind, see, thoughts are like sheep that keep going astray, turning every way to its own way. That's why the man that is double-minded, let him not think he will receive anything of the Lord. And that's why some people are just existing. They don't receive anything from the Lord because they never disciplined their thoughts and brought it into focus. And once you can bring that into focus, you can be sitting up in business meetings and just sit there with the rope, just going one at a time, and whole conversation say, yeah, I agree with that. And while they're talking, I am my father financially won. I am my father financially won. I am my father financially won. Did you hear me? Yeah, I heard everything that you said. You said that, and you stay locked in that beat. And so you begin to know, says, you know what? My finger has not moved from this knot in 10 minutes because my thoughts are wandering. Let me bring those sheep back in and start all over. Because see, if you start to understand, you begin to see how undisciplined the mind is. And how your thoughts would just wander. And I would find that at night, that when I would wake up, there'd be some nights I held onto the rope all night and kept going in an unconscious state. But there were some nights the rope got lost in the bed. And I knew that I had lost that connect. And so when we start really coming forth as masters, is going to call us to discipline and rope in our thoughts. Because I think the reason why he's going to wipe the tears from our eyes, because we're going to, because in eternity he's going to show us, says, I had all these millions of angels just encamped around you, just waiting for you to voice the word. And you just looked at television all day. You just heard bad news all day. And the angels are sitting around you saying, please tell me something to do. Just voice a word so that I can hearken to a command. I want to hearken diligently to the voice of his word. I am excelling in strength. My strength is built up. I am commanded to do his commandment. I encamp around you waiting and hearken unto the voice of the word. Just give me something to do. And your angel sit there. And so your angel's going to sit there and show you, says, here's all the room of stuff that was for you. But you've never hearkened me to bring it to you. So I had to sit there and wait. And every once in a while, you would slip up and say, I am that. And I would sit there and listen to you until you say, I'm that. I said, I think they really believe in that. I am that. They are that. I'm hearkening to the voice of that word. And it shows up. And after you got your blessing, you relaxed. And you only used me in emergencies. See, we're going to cry. You mean tell me I could have been living over there instead of here? You mean I could have been having this? You mean all of that struggle? You mean that's when you're going to try to talk God into say, send me back again. Send me back to earth again. And you're going to sit there and say, I will send you back to earth again, but you got to come to earth forgetting. I promise I'm not going to forget this time. I'm going to remember. He says, you know, that's the earthly experience. You come forgetting. And true salvation is remembering. Amen. Okay, we'll close. Amen. Stay tuned and we'll be right back.